is going on. So I don't know anything about this Assange fella, who is the head of the WikiLeaks Foundation, and he's the one leaking all this information. I don't know anything about him. But I do know that there's a lot of people in government and in businesses and in different places all over the world that are kind of nervous. They're kind of nervous. Why are they nervous? Because apparently they have been doing things in secret. They have been doing things behind people's backs. You know, they put up a big corporate smiley face, like Walmart. Save money, live better, okay? And oh, by the way, we're watching you. Don't make a false move. See, they make it sound really nice, okay? Kind of makes you wonder what sort of backdoor deal went on behind the scenes for Janet Napolitano, the big sis of America, to get cameras and to get warning signs placed all over Walmart's stores. What kind of deal went on here? Okay, I guarantee you, Walmart didn't just say, "Hey, we're good Americans. We want to help." That's not what happened. Backdoor deals are done everywhere, in Congress, everywhere, in businesses, everywhere. The problem is, let me illustrate here. This is Morals and Dogma. This book would represent government inside secret classified meetings that they don't want anybody to know. And it doesn't have anything to do with national security. It doesn't have anything to do with telling the Iranians where all of our warships are. It has everything to do with a bunch of dirty politicians who want to gain power and money behind everybody's back, and the taxpayers paying for it. But they don't want you to find out that that's how they did it. It has to do with the United States of America and the power structure in America not even trusting our own allies, not even trusting them, and having the NSA and the CIA spy and intercept cables and wiretaps and everything like on people that are our allies. That's what it has to do with. They want to keep it secret. Albert Pike says this is an esoteric book. Nobody can know what's inside of here. Okay? And yet God says, I reveal the deep and secret things. God said that there is nothing that is done in secret that shall not be brought to light. Nothing. So, what do I think of the WikiLeaks guy as a person? I don't know. What do I think about massive amounts of documents that are coming to the light of day that expose the fraud, the corruption, the backdoor deals, and everything like that, that if and when the public finds out about it, there would be a massive outcry. I think I'm in favor of that. I really do. I think I'm in favor of that. Something that the conspiracy theorists have held for a while is that the government has inside information on UFOs. Now, here is one of the alleged stories from WikiLeaks. Apparently, WikiLeaks has another bundle of documents that they have sent out in an encrypted package to all over the world. There's no way to stop this now. And it requires a 250-some-odd character code in order to break it. Not even the NSA can break it. Not even the military. So apparently they have this out there, and they say, if anything happens to us, if anything happens to me, we're going to open the package. Okay, we're going to let it all out. And apparently, here's an article here, WikiLeaks, new diplomatic cables contain UFO details. Julian Assange says, new leaked diplomatic cables set to be published by WikiLeaks will contain fresh details on UFOs, according to the website's founder, Julian Assange. So, we don't know what's in the package. We don't know what details there is. We don't know what documents there are. But apparently, somebody knows something. Now, Pastor Mike, do you believe in UFOs? Yes, I believe that there are things that are flying in the sky that people have not identified. Do you believe in alien life forms? Yes, I do. You believe they live on other planets? No. I believe that they are evil angels. The Bible talks about that very specifically. They are full of lying signs and wonders is what they are. They represent the familiar spirits that have been in contact with man, with governments. We know that Hitler was involved in it. We speculate that there were areas of the United States government, the Majestic 12 and all this stuff. And I haven't really reported much on this, but I kind of know some things about it. I don't have a problem in the world believing that some of the technology that we have, that our military has or other areas in life have, is being directed toward mankind by aliens, by fallen angels, evil angels, the Bible calls them, in order to bring about a scenario where the world is going to turn away from the Bible and turn toward worshiping Lucifer. That is what I believe according to the scriptures. So far, it's conspiracy theory. We'll wait to see what happens in the future. Here is something that we do know about. Cancun starts talk with a call to the gods, while with the United Nations climate negotiators facing an uphill battle to advance their goal of reducing emissions leaked a global warning. It's because global warming just isn't true. It's no surprise that the woman steering the talks appealed to a Mayan goddess Monday. Cristina Figueres, executive secretary of the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. See, it's not global warming anymore, it's climate. They can't make up their mind. Invoked the ancient jaguar goddess in her opening statement to delegates gathered in Cancun, Mexico, which, by the way, a cold front moved into Cancun. It's freezing them all out. They're having a global warming meeting down there. Noting that Ixchel was not only goddess of the moon, but also the goddess of reason, creativity, and weaving. May she inspire you, because today you're gathered in Cancun to weave together the elements, think about the wording here, of a solid response to climate change using both reason and creativity as your tools. She called for a balanced outcome. These are all code words, by the way, which would marry financial and emissions commitments from industrialized countries aimed at combating climate change with, quote, the understanding of fairness that will guide long-term mitigation efforts. You see the picture here. UN Climate Chief Cristina Figueres places a building block in a miniature Mayan pyramid at the site of the climate negotiations in Cancun, Mexico, Sunday, November 28, 2010. It's called the Pyramid of Hope Monument. It was erected by the Tick, Tick, Tick Climate Awareness Campaign. That's just a funny name. Climate Awareness Campaign to symbolize the many building blocks needed for a new climate agreement. Stop right there. They're building a pyramid of hope. They're wanting to change.